Hello guys, this is Nerdmist and today's video is going to be an unboxing video. So yes, that's the box of the Beyblade which I'm going to unbox, and mind you, it's really a superb Beyblade. So before we begin this unboxing, if you guys already don't know, I and Ramp Hobbies are working on a India exclusive giveaway. Yes, you heard right. It's an India exclusive giveaway, so definitely enter this giveaway. I have provided both the links of my video and their video in the description of this video. So definitely go today only and check those two videos out and enter the giveaway, because see, it's India exclusive giveaway. So only the Indians have a chance to enter this giveaway, and definitely one of you will win this. And the prize is not something very less or something like that. It's a huge Beyblade which is Lucifer the End. So that's a very neat and new Beyblade, and it's going to be completely for free, right? It's a giveaway, so you would get it for free. And definitely enter, because it's a chance for us to like interact with the rest of the world and let people know that we as Indians also exist in Beyblade. So show our strength to all these people around the world, and hit the like button on both the videos and definitely enter the giveaway. So without any further talking, let's begin with the unboxing. So the special Beyblade which I'm going to talk about is actually, there is a small story about it. It's like I searched about this Beyblade on YouTube, but I couldn't get any relevant unboxings. So I finally got this Beyblade, and I thought I would just unbox it by my own hand. So the Beyblade is none other than Kai's Dronzer F. So this one of the prestigious Beyblade which Kai owned during the V4 series and the start of the V4 series and the end of the first season. So this Beyblade was so good that Kai had kept it in a shelf where he had like stopped blading, as he couldn't find any worthy opponents and the blade breakers had also split apart. So this is one of the iconic Beyblades in Kai's arsenal. So let's unbox this Beyblade. It's really a super Beyblade, and we do have a burst remake of this Beyblade which I'm definitely going to compare. So we get a yellow launcher with this Beyblade, and we get some other things as well. Yeah, so let's begin. So first the stickers. There are very few stickers, but they are very elegant when they go on the Beyblade. So definitely the stickers are worth it for this Beyblade. And most of the Beyblades, there are very few Beyblades where the stickers don't have any effect. So this is the sticker sheet, the extra sticker sheet of a generic Bit Beast. The ring inside the Beyblade, the weight inside the spin gear. And there is a comic kind of brochure here which talks about, I guess, different toys of Takara Tomy. Yeah, wow. So who knew Takara Tomy had so many toys, right? Some of us don't even know. This is Betamon, if you guys don't know already. And you can get all the parts and all of the plastic generations of the first season. So that's really cool. This is the box. We'll keep it aside. And let's get started with the main thing now. It's been a long time. I also unboxed the plastic generation Beyblade. So damn man, it's really nostalgic to get this plastic generation Beyblades and unbox them. So let me just adjust the camera once. So this is the winder which we get with the Beyblade. It is pretty neat, the standard one which we get with all the Beyblades. And we get the instruction sheet also, or the instruction manual, which we will go through if we need. So plastic generations are something which sometimes do require an instruction sheet. But anyways, let's keep it aside for now. And the blade base, let's take out the weight disc. Okay, there is a way to remove the weight disc. The attack ring, the Dronzer F attack ring. So very iconic and prestigious. This is the spin gear core, also later known in the MFP series as Delta Drive. like many of my fans might be from the MFB series, right? So for you to make sense from this, yep, so these are the parts. We would keep this aside, and the outer spin gear. These are few of the very iconic Beyblades which the Blade Breakers had owned. Like the same one I am still finding for a Drigger F actually, because that also was one of the most iconic Beyblades Ray had at that time, where that Beyblade was so damn powerful, where Kenny had engineered it to be like a monster. So let's start with the assembly now, guys. Yes, so the first things first, we would take these two parts and join them. Okay, no, we cannot just join them. That was stupid of me to just join them. We would have to insert one of these tabs you can see here inside this, like so, and then we would case the other half, which is so small, so damn small for my hands. But anyways, yep, so that's the inner core which is now built, and this is something which will rotate as the Beyblade wants to change its attribute. So let's put the ring on the top, shall we? And the outer metal casing, the plastic casing, not the metal one. If this was metal, it would have been really cool, but no, it's not metal. Yep, so that's the core of this super Beyblade Dronzer F, and I hope you guys know what Dronzer F stands for. So I would definitely like you all to right now comment down below what Dronzer F stands for. So quickly just go down below and comment, what does F here stand for, because F is there in all the Blade Breakers and they have this naming for most, like all the Beyblades, they have the same naming always. So what does this F and all stand for? So let me know in the comments down below now, and then come back and continue. So okay, I just forgot the tabs which will hold the Beyblade together. See, these Beyblades are something which you watch the full unboxing, because it's really cool to watch their unboxing, because they are not simple as the Burst Gen or the MFB Gen Beyblades. They have a lot of complex parts involved in it. As you can see, I'm struggling to get this in. Oh god, that was quite sharp, this part which has come out here. They have a lot of parts and a series of assembly required to get these Beyblades into working order. So these unboxings are really cool actually. Like the burst ones, definitely people skip and all, because they are the same most of the time, unless and until the person who is unboxing gives some intricate details about the Beyblades. But this is something I also have not unboxed for a long time. So yes, that's the Dronzer F in all its glory without the stickers. So guys, I would be back in a moment, and stay tuned so that I would just apply the sticker sheets and be right back. Yes guys, we are back with all the stickers completed. So final product, Dronzer F. So as you can see, now it looks like the Red Phoenix it deserves to be. So this is the plastic generation one, and I do have, I believe it was here only, just a second. So this is the plastic generation one. Yep. So here is the burst generation one, which comes with the attack ring, then yell disc, which is fine. But then the driver, at least they could have made this part as red to have some resemblance. Like if whenever you are making a remake, you at least try to have some resemblance between them. At least like not the performance and all, but at least the colors. Nothing as such. So there you can see the stickers and all are fine. They have been given the exact same look, little bit here and there. It's cool. This one looks so damn bulky and this is so damn sharp. I don't know why did they make it like a puffy bronzer F, but yeah, sad. So anyways, this is my unboxing of the beautiful Phoenix, the Red Phoenix Bronzer F. So if you guys like the unboxing, definitely like the video and share it with your friends. And we have a lot of more Plastic Generation unboxings with us and even Burst as well. So definitely keep on checking the channel out. So take care guys and see you in the next video.